I was wrong in the last video. ChatGPT was also wrong with their trivial multiplication error. And still I got twice as many views as my best video until now. I thank you very much. I feel the responsibility to give you value and got to work like crazy. And now I present you the Sand Battery 2.0, a storage without loss. I hope you will be satisfied. Hi Energy Champions, it's great to see you back on the channel. In the last video, we explored the Sand Battery, estimating that it could heat energy for several months. But then I read a comment and after a check, I realized that I made a miscalculation. So the 1 cubic meter Sand Battery is not suitable for long-term or seasonable heat storage. But I come with something better. Also, in video 64, about the seasonal energy storage of ice, there was a similar miscalculation. ChatGPT made a simple multiplication error that I skipped in my trust of AI to do these simple calculations. I want to apologize for the miscalculation. The responsibility with a growing audience stimulated me to find solutions that could restore the trust in the Sand Battery as a principle for energy storage. It's one step back and two steps forward. Let's hope that it is like penicillin that was discovered because Alexander Fleming forgot to clean his petri dishes. Now, what happens exactly in the calculation of video 64 about ice storage? I estimated that 1 cubic meter of ice could store cold energy for as long as 5 months. With a melt of only 5% of ice and a reasonable thin insulation. During the calculation of the thickness of the insulation layer, ChatGPT literally states this calculation here. With the conduction constant, the area of the insulation, the temperature difference, and the admitted power loss, which is an error of 100 times. Of course, it's my responsibility to discover this. No excuse from my side about AI failing in simple calculations. And the same happened with the Sand Battery. It will not happen again, and I will put a warning in the descriptions of the affected videos. Therefore, Sand Batteries are short-term and not seasonal. This means holding heat for a couple of days. And you know what? That's still very useful. And why? Sand batteries can store electricity from off-grid hours or excess renewable energy, and that can be life-saving during emergencies. A sand battery can keep a house warm for days without grid power if kept under charge. Of course, keeping it at a high temperature all the time, waiting for a blackout that never comes, is frustrating because it's losing heat all the time. Now, if you pick up just that heat that is coming out of the surface and use it, you can't call it loss anymore. The second improvement is to keep the sand cool near the wall so that the insulation will have a smaller temperature difference. That sounds weird, isn't it? Cooling something when we want it to be hot. No, what we want is energy, not just the temperature. That brings us to phase change materials. They stay at a reduced temperature, for example 140 degrees, while storing a lot of energy during the melting process. Only when this material is molten for 100%, the temperature will rise again further. Another way to keep the insulation material cool and at a lower budget is to pick up the heat from the inside of the insulation material. A metal spiral at the inside of the insulation can pick up the heat at those 140 degrees or a similar temperature and use it for higher temperature demands, for example space heating or domestic hot water. If you want, you can control that automatically. Before going into the details of construction and even a small prototype, let me tell you why I am doing this. We are living in a world with increasing climate risks, from tornadoes to extreme temperatures. Just in July, so many people in southeastern United States were left without power for days. Imagine a similar situation in winter, in a cold winter, like in Texas 3 years ago, also with many blackouts. I think that we normal folks must come together in a community to leverage do-it-yourself to take our daily lives and the energy situation under control and at the same time contribute to a safer climate. So if you are new here or haven't subscribed yet, consider hitting that button and joining this community of innovators and do-it-yourselfers. And if you know someone who has been affected by blackouts or energy costs, share this video with them. I thank you very much in advance. Now, here's what I propose for the improved sand battery design, which has four main components. The core of 1 cubic meter of sand. It's affordable, it's safe, and it can reach very high temperatures. I propose only 1 cubic meter to limit the cost and also the amount of space that you need at your home. After all, we are talking about emergency solutions, not about covering the whole house. A peripheral layer of phase change material around the sand core. This helps to increase the overall heat capacity, lower the temperature near the wall, and reduce losses. A metal spiral close to the PCM, or in its absence, it will cool the sand battery near the wall and recover medium temperature heat. This can become an active element to regulate the temperature at the wall as you want. And then the hollow bricks. Surrounding everything, we put hollow bricks to capture low temperature heat loss and make this loss useful for other applications like fresh air preheating before it comes into your home. These bricks will form vertical channels around your sand battery, and at the top you have to lay bricks that form a horizontal ring to collect the heat. These bricks have usually 2x4 channels. The outer row can be used to recover heat, and the inner row can be filled with PCM. With this configuration, we can eliminate the word heat loss. A nice idea also for the cold days in autumn. Let me now show what I'm working on as a prototype. This is a simple, small-scale version, but much bigger than last week, also with heat recovery and cooling of the outer wall. You see here at the lower line also the kilowatt hours. Now let's talk about phase change materials. I found that using eutectic mixtures of nitrates requires about 33 kilograms and 230 euros per kilowatt hour, per kilowatt hour of storage capacity. These materials have a variable melting point, for example 140 degrees. By mixing sodium nitrate and potassium nitrate in the right proportion, they are easily available and stable up to 400 degrees. For a PCM demonstration, I need more time. Certain is that the hollow bricks are a very exciting low-cost option to combine in one stone the PCM and the low-temperature heat recovery. Stay tuned for other videos, always about energy and do-it-yourself. Feel free to leave comments, suggestions or questions below. See you next time. And as always, stay empowered and resilient.